Hey there guys, it's Chris. Thanks again for watching another episode of Behind the Words of the book Blade Children, which you can buy right now in several different versions at westbowpress.com or the website at bladechildren.com. And while you're on the web, make sure to check out the Facebook page and become a fan there. And stay tuned for a special message coming pretty soon at facebook.com/bladechildrenbook. And we really appreciate you guys helping us spread the word by liking it and sharing it with your friends and telling everyone you can about it. So here's the thing I kind of want to do today, guys. If you've watched episode 4 and 5, we've kind of been on this journey of going over some of the characters in the book and how they kind of portray to our own lives and some lessons we can learn from that. So if you're a perfectionist, you kind of knew what the next character was going to be. And I just ask that you please forgive me because I'm going to change it up a little bit and switch gears. Something recently in the past few weeks have kind of happened in my life, and our character Kai experienced this as well, and I guarantee you, I might not know anything about you, but you've experienced this in your own life, and it's the word forgiveness. Yeah, that's what I thought. We've all heard it before, right? Well, throughout the book, our character Kai and his brother Max and their angels have to learn a little bit about this word forgiveness. But nothing compares towards the very end of the book, where Kai is faced with the most tragic decision of his life, is either to forgive someone who has truly wronged him and his family, or to not forgive them. And if we're all honest with ourselves, we've been placed in that very situation to where we have been wronged by somebody, and we either have to forgive them or not forgive them. Some of us may even be honest and say, no, I've forgiven them, but deep down inside, we really haven't forgiven them. You know, a quote I heard one time, and this is paraphrasing because I don't really remember if this is correct or not, but basically it said that you know you've truly forgiven somebody when you see the person that's wronged you and you wish them well. So just with that quote alone, how many of us can actually say, I have truly forgiven that person who's wronged me? You know, one thing I've learned in my very recent history here of me relearning this life lesson is at the very moment you take up your sword, which basically you take matters into your own hands to defend yourself, is the very moment that God stops defending you. And so I just want to remind each and every one of us is that defending yourself, I know, comes naturally, but we need to have forgiveness be the first thing that comes out. A lot of us will like to maybe defend ourselves by building walls and maybe withdrawing away from that person. Or some of us might be, like I said, kind of taking up a sword to, attack. But that's not what we should be doing. We should be forgiving. And I know it's easier said than done, but it all kind of comes down to this one scripture in the Bible that says this. In Matthew chapter 6, verse 14 and 15, it says, "For if you forgive other people when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you of your sins. But if you do not forgive others of their sins, your heavenly Father will not forgive you of yours." Yikes. I mean, there's no way around that, right? I mean, if God said it, it is said and it is done. You cannot go around that. And I know that there are so many times in our lives to where someone has done something wrong against us, and maybe we have just distanced ourselves from them, or vice versa, they've distanced themselves from you, knowing that what they did was wrong, and they don't want to face the truth, then how do you ultimately forgive them? You have to let it go. Because by us holding on to bitterness and unforgiveness literally puts us in bondage. It'll bind us with anger and hate, maybe stress and depression. And the only way to be free from any of that bondage is by ultimately forgiving them. Another version in Mark 11:25 says that if you just stop to pray to God, just to have your normal everyday communication and relationship with him, but yet you have something against your neighbor over there, you still are harvesting that unforgiveness, it actually says to stop what you're doing, go forgive that person, or God still won't forgive you of yours. See, literally, not only does it put you in that bondage of everything that I just mentioned, but it also puts you in bondage and hinders your own relationship with the God of the universe. And even our own character, Kai, in the book Blade Children, had to learn this life lesson. And I know it's something we're always going to be learning over and over and over again. But today, this month, I just wanted to encourage each and every one of you guys, if there's someone out there, rather it's a sibling, rather it's a spouse, rather it's a boss, a coworker, whoever, You need to forgive them if they have done something wrong against you. Completely let it go. And you know what? You're probably going to have to forgive them over and over and over again in your own mind and in your own heart for the same offense every day. So tomorrow you're going to have to say it again. I forgive them and I forgive them and I forgive them. And again the next day until ultimately it's completely released and it's in God's hands. Guys, I just want to encourage you with that today. I hope it helps somebody out. Below is a link to a kind of a blog that I posted about this very recent thing that's happened, and it gives a little bit more information, a little bit more scripture into how you can have that forgiveness in your life for somebody who's done something wrong. So I love you guys. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next month.
It'll clear the bitterness away. It can even set a prisoner free. There is no end to what its power can do. So let it go and be amazed by what you see through eyes of grace. The prisoner that it really frees is you. Forgiveness. Forgiveness.